Hi, I'm Grace Hill, and I'm a senior at Shakopee High School. If you could please bow your heads and join me in prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us all here for an amazing weekend of service and growth. Amen. So, my whole life, church has been something that has always been there, but over these past couple of years, it's become so much more than that. It has helped me become who I am today and has taught me a lot about how to love and serve others around me. Now, I'm not going to lie to you and say that I've always loved church, because when I was younger, I used to really dislike going to church.
No.
The morning of, I would try to come up with excuses like I was sick or I don't feel good. It usually didn't work. Along with going to church services on Sundays, I would also have choir on Wednesday night, and it wasn't really my thing. When we joined the church and I started choir, I didn't really enjoy it until third or fourth grade. That was when I really started to like going to church, because that is when I started to become friends with some of the people from my previous choir years. Choir at church has really helped me come out of my shell more, because even though it may not seem like it when I'm doing announcements with Chloe or I'm dancing up at the front, I can be really shy, and it was even worse when I was younger. When I would get up and sing in front of everyone with my dad and sister, I was terrified and could not stand still. I was quiet and didn't really want to be there, but being in choir really helped me get over that. I still remember the first time I ever sang a whole song by myself, and it was here at Camp Onomia, and I sang Sanctuary for the Thursday talent show. I was so nervous at the beginning, but I was so proud of myself, and even though I still get really nervous to get up and sing in front of people, I really like being up there, especially when it's with my sister. Ever since then, music has been a huge part of my life. My sister and I used to do these little programs at a nursing home with my grandma and my cousin. I've been in band since fifth grade, and I've been in some type of choir since I think I was like 4 years old, and all of it has helped me so much, along with my family, who I adore with all my heart, my faith, and Anna Nelson, along with some of my other friends. School has been the biggest struggle because it has caused a lot of tension between my parents and I. It has been really hard for me to get the work done because I have a really hard time focusing on the work. It has been really hard. The work itself wasn't necessarily hard, but no matter where I am and what's around me, I still manage to get distracted by something, whether it's an object in the room, a song that's playing, or my own thoughts. This would get me into trouble because if I was distracted, I wasn't getting my work done. So my parents would get really annoyed and frustrated. It caused a lot of arguments, and that made things even worse because when I'm super frustrated and stressed, I'm not gonna be able to get anything done, and that causes even more arguments. Now, I'm really bad at expressing my feelings when it comes to being angry, annoyed, or upset with people, because if it's about them, I don't want them to feel bad, but at the same time, it would build up, and I ended up taking it out on myself multiple times. I would get so worked up with everything that was being kept inside, and I didn't want to yell or say anything to my mom, so I would hurt myself. My mom found out about this worst one, which is a scar on my arm from ninth grade, and I would do other self-harm. Whenever I would get like this, or whenever I would get super stressed, I listened to music, and at least during these times, I would listen to worship music. I would listen to songs that Servant Song sings, like All the People Said Amen, or I would listen to confirmation songs like Days of Elijah and Every Move I Make. These songs would make me smile and I would relax, and I still do this to this day. I have a whole playlist on YouTube of some of my favorite worship songs that I like to listen to because they make me happy. There are a couple of songs in particular that really helped me when I was having a hard time last year. The last few years have been really hard because the arguing got really bad. I've been having a really hard time with feeling like I fit in, and I've had a really hard time knowing my self-worth. I was feeling really lonely because I didn't feel like any of my friends liked me, and they were just hanging out with me out of pity because I always felt like I was being ignored by them. Which, it doesn't help that I'm not the greatest at joining in on conversations, but I was just having a rough time feeling like I belonged with anyone. I would ask myself questions about why I'm not good enough and why can't I do anything right. I would wonder why people were friends with me and why am I not a good person. Because even though I know that I will always have God in my family, I still felt so lonely and still struggle with that. It got to a point last year where my mom and I got into a really bad argument while I was working, and I was so worked up that I couldn't do my work anymore. I decided to go upstairs, and everything in my head felt like it was going a million miles a second with all kinds of thoughts, and I wondered what it would be like if I was just gone. I had only ever had a couple of thoughts like this before, and I know that I could never do anything like that, so the fact that something like that even came up in my mind was terrifying. The first thing I did was text my sister, because even though I usually keep everything hidden, I knew that this was something I couldn't keep locked away. The next thing I did was turn on the song every day. For a lot of people, they are able to connect really well to Bible verses, but my go-to is music. And in the chorus of the song every day, they sing, "Every day it's you I live for. Every day I'll follow after you. Every day I'll walk with you, my Lord." I listened to that song and I just cried. In the past, whenever I would have a thought about hurting myself or running away, I would always think about how it would affect my friends and family. That was always my first thought that ran through my head. Then I would think about how God sent Jesus to earth to die for our sins and how we need to live it to the best we can so that we can honor him and his son. I knew that if I did anything to myself, not only would I be dishonoring what we are here for, but I would also be hurting all of the people that I love and all of the people that love me. Now, I'm gonna play a different song that has helped me, and it's called "You Love Me Anyway." I chose this song by the Sidewalk Prophets, because like the name of the song says, is that he loves us no matter what. He will love us forever. Another thing that helped me get through all of this and helped me feel better and feeling lonely was serving. Serving has been something that has always made me feel good and worthy. There is something that I found on Emmanuel's website that I think is important to think about while serving. On the welcome page of the website, it says, "Everyone is welcome. You are welcome here. You are welcome to share God's love and grace. You are welcome no matter your race or culture, sexual orientation, gender identity, or relationship status. You are welcome without regard to physical or mental health, addictions, past mistakes, or socioeconomic circumstances, political opinions, or anything that divides us. We welcome you because our unity is in Christ. All are welcome, no exceptions. I really like this because when I am serving someone, I shouldn't be thinking about what's happened to them in the past, but focused on what's happening with them now. As I was looking at the guide to help me prepare, one of the suggested verses was Micah chapter 6, verse 8, and it said, "What does the Lord require of you, but to act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God?" I thought that this would be a good verse to use because I really liked it. And then on Wednesday, I saw it in one of the walls in the Sunday school hallway. As I was looking at this, I thought about all of these things and how even if I'm thinking about all of the things that I shouldn't do, I can't, if I'm thinking about all of these things, I shouldn't do any of them because he sent his son to die for me. I should be living my life in the best way I can and serve those in need. I've been able to serve and follow this by going on mission trips, and they have been some of the greatest experiences I have ever had. So far, I've been able to go on 5, and I have gained something special from each one of them that I never want to let go of. If you can go on one, I strongly suggest going on as many mission trips as you can, because I've made so many amazing memories from them because of the people from church, the people from other churches, and the people that we got to serve in the communities. I know that I will never forget the card games played, the kids that I've met, and the community members that were there. Thinking back on what has happened, I have realized that even if I don't think I am worth that much, I know that I can think back on this past mission trip to Logan, West Virginia. My little work crew called the Thundering Herd got to go and help kids read, and even though there wasn't much reading that happened, I really connected with some of the girls in my room. See, we were split up into a couple of rooms at the school, and because I love all kids, I didn't really care what age I was with. So Alex Pastor and I ended... So Alex Pastor and I ended up going to a room with a bunch of kids going into 6th grade. When we first got there, it was a little awkward at first, but one of the girls wanted one of us to go sit by her. So I did, and once we were done reading, I decided to start drawing in a notebook I brought with. And some of the kids thought some of the drawings were pretty cool. This led to me drawing them pictures and them drawing me some pictures, and it was so much fun. The next day, we went back because we were supposed to be building stairs, but it was too rainy, so we went back and we all decided to go back to the same rooms we were in the day before. And one of the girls named Emily from the day before saw me come into the classroom and ran up to me and gave me a big hug and said, "I told you you would come back." She was a pretty sassy kid, but it felt so cool to see her so happy and all of the other kids so happy to see us back there. At one point, she asked if she could have one of the highlighters that I had brought with me, and I didn't really want to at first because they were really nice highlighters, but I knew that I could always get another one, so I let her have it, and her smile was so big. There was one other girl who I really connected with, and her name was Natalie. She wasn't there on the first day, so she was a little more quiet than the other kids, even though it wasn't that hard to be more quiet than them. They were pretty loud. Some of the girls and I were drawing again, and I asked if she wanted to draw and asked her if she wanted to sit by me, but she would always politely decline. But as the day went on, she kind of opened up a little more. She was sitting by me in the gym/lunchroom, and before she left, she asked me if I wanted to be friends with her, and I thought that was so sweet. She hadn't even known me for 5 hours, and she wanted to be friends with me. I look back on that now, and I think about how this is what I am here for. I am here to serve and help others, whether it's to just be a friend and draw with some kids, singing music in church, or doing something a little bit bigger. I figured out that I love to serve and go on mission trips, do service projects, and volunteer at different places because it is so rewarding to know that I was able to make someone's day, even if it is only for a little bit of time. I've also been able to become a student leader, which is one of my favorite things. I didn't have the best experience with my small group as a student, but I'm having so much fun being a student leader and watching all of my kids grow as people and grow in their faith. I hope I'm a good student leader and I'm being a welcoming person to not only the kids in my group, but also the kids in all of the other groups. The family I've made at church has made me so happy over the past couple of years, and I always look forward to going to church and doing everything I can. I've made some of my best friends who I know that if there is a day where I am a mess, I can go to them and cry it out and talk to them about it. Confirmation has been one of the many highlights of my high school years, and even if I do get teased like a sibling a little bit in my small group, I know that they will always bring a smile to my face. Because of the community here at church, I have been thinking about how I want to be able to do something with kids and ministry, because I want to be able to make a difference in people's lives because how I view some of the things in my life has changed so much, and I don't know what it would be like if my parents hadn't made me come to church every Sunday and Wednesday when I was younger. One of my favorite stories in the Bible is of the lady who gives the two pennies, because even though it looked like nothing compared to what everyone else was giving, it meant everything. I think it's important to be kind and help people out as much as we can, because even if it seems like it's nothing to you, it might seem like everything to another person. The feeling of helping someone and knowing it made at least a little bit of their day is everything to me. And I think that the ability to give is something that everyone is capable of doing. The music I've learned is amazing, and I still remember most of the actions to the songs that I learned during summer camp here and songs that I've learned at the 10:45 service. This church is my home, and that might sound a little cheesy, but I guess everyone can use a little cheesiness in their lives, even if they don't like it. If you could please bow your heads and pray with me one more time. Dear Lord, please help everyone find their place and know their worth, because we are all grateful for the love you give us. Help us to serve one another in our community and outside of our community, and continue to grow in our faith. Amen.